Sound resumed. Microphone activated. Welcome back.
I think I had my sound made, but... Great, we're back now. I was quite quick because I only had to cook something for like 10 minutes, so... what was it now? I've done my... That's the glitch one. Done all the quests. You know, everything else kind of thing. I just put a tweet out and it's already got quoted apparently. I think. You expect old Greg. Okay. I don't know, I'm quite tempted to go for the Floran though. So I got my glitch, got my avian, got my avian kid, they're all done. Quests all done, the ship's got as far as possible they can get. I mean obviously the avian is going to be done again because this one I've done before I did the stream, but I'm not deleting it. This is my main character and I'm keeping it. So let's see. I'm quite tempted to go for this one. Because I haven't done Floran. I have done the Hayato before, so I know roughly what the ship's going to look like. Whereas the Floran, I actually haven't done a Floran one. So I don't know what that's really going to look like. Same as these two, I have no idea what their ships really look like. Oh, that's like two different rows. Blue rose, red rose. Everyone else is like the same, except these two have their own different like way of telling their genders apart, apparently. You feel your feet burning. Okay, flower power. Yeah, flower power. Okay, yeah. So got Reva, Reva Kins, Reva Hakushia. I need to come up with something different, I think. Oh, this is not what I'm gonna do. I might make a red font. Oh, I can have red. Okay. Foliage. Oh god, that looks weird. No, 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 no. Wow. I have no foliage. Make another Reba, but obviously because I mean I can't tell them apart by names anyway. It'll be like UUID stuff anyway. I need something Reba. Something Reba, like a Reba flower name. That's what I really need. We'll look up flower names real quick. No. Name of flowers. We've got Reva Bell. That's like, no. Reva Lily. How about Reva Lily? Reva Lily sounds nice. Reva... Reva Nadurius. No. I think Reva Lily's a bit easier to say. Also... A little bit easier, I think. I'm gonna get Reva Lily. What with that? I could give that a hairstyle. That's cool. That's not a good hair. Blue and red. There we go, we'll go with that. Now obviously I've got to put the BRB screen back up because obviously password and everything. So 1 second guys. The game gone, there we go. Watch it, you cannot show the password. I have a snake. Pet snake. It's kind of like bones and plants and mechanical stuff. It's very weird. What the hell is that? That's supposed to be like a training dummy. I think that's supposed to be a training dummy. That looks... wow, okay. That was fucking crazy. Ain't kidding there. Really? Your nightmare, is it? Aw, oh, poor Tibbetts. That's the part, isn't it? Because I'm on the server, I'm not going to be able to get any of these stuff. That. Hey, PF5068, how you doing? Is it really, Tim? Is it really that scary? I'm doing good, good. Good to hear. Can't cut any trees here, that's the problem. Everything's protected, so it's like, yeah. The thing of nightmares, yes. Probably gonna have to go in single player. That the I'll be checking in the community mall. There might be some stuff in the community mall that allows me to go and get what I need to get, but we'll see. Oh, that's where you get the filler up thing from that, okay. Did wonder. Oh, it's a tree, Tibbers. It's kind of not the same, I don't think. Oh my god, is this Terraria? Yeah, yeah. Totally Terraria. Right, now that's gonna be Doctor Who stuff, I don't want that. It's like a very distant cousin. How about that? We'll say it's a very distant cousin. Get the core fragments from here, but I don't really want core fragments. What I really would like right now is some wood. Even just a crafting table, you know? Hey Murray, how you doing? People are getting a little bit aggressive in the chat. Nice. Mention that so they can calm their asses down and chat, or at least take it to there's always like one or two people that suddenly come on and start doing that shit, and it's like, really, you know, there's no age limit to the game. Think that there could be younger kids playing. Could you like keep it to planet chat? No, this isn't Neverkid, no, this is now Floran. I'm now on to my third new character, so already completed Neverkid a while ago now. Yep, I don't think there's anything. I might have to go single player to get what I need to get, which is to get some wood. No one sells wood at the mall. It'd be nice if they sold the starter bits that you can't get in the spawn because you can't get out of spawn. Just to kind of like say, well, you know, here you go. Because otherwise you have to do it in single player. But I don't necessarily have to play this on multiplayer, but I think it's a lot better too. And I got this really bad feeling that those people are going to get really kind of weird in chat real soon. Which, if that's the case, then always screenshots. Right. I might have to go single player just to do this bit. just to get past the first little bits, because anywhere to really dig. And I can't. Any cool fragments? I could go get them from the mall, actually. Wow, really? Crazy. Yeah, it does. Yeah. Yeah, I didn't bother getting anything from here. I just kind of like went along and picked them up as I went to planets. Much more better. Good. I don't have to actually go and pay for the fragments, I can get them whenever. Yeah. Nice little bit of bones at the front there, you know. I must have crashed into something along the way, I think, and I just haven't got any window wipers installed, so, you know, it's kind of stuck there. Fortunately, they don't do any, like, car washes in space, so a bit stuck. Get this bit done. Yep. Better let's see. It does look, but yeah, although again, I don't know what the human ship looks like, but it kind of looks like the ship that they had before you even had the different races ships, like when it was all just the same ship kind of thing. At least I think it was like very similar ships right at the beginning. You could never upgrade. Always the same size. Now I know once you get past a certain point you can buy the fuel and the crystals here. But I can't do that until I beat the boss though, that's the annoying thing. I don't even have a wooden one yet, so yes I would. I would if you know. Suddenly with it? No. Okay, so probably I'm gonna have to go single player here just to get the first couple of quests done. Crafting table and get a few more minerals and stuff, like get actual minerals and that. Otherwise I'm not gonna be able to do anything on the server, because I think that's the problem with the server, is that it's good, you can play everyone, but you've got to do the most basic part in single player in order to really go and play with anyone. Unless you know someone on the server who's already out of the spawn area. Which again, if everyone's all started new, it's not gonna happen. So, come out of this bit. Single player. Put this way, be easier. Hey, where's the planets? There isn't. I can't beam down, there's no planet. Why have I got a thing that's like a trick thing? Well, it's just, there's no trees in the spawn area unless I'm missing something, but I could never figure it out, and I didn't want to go to all the different planets because if you look at the solar system they're in, all the planets are dangerous. I mean, it could be those planets there you can use, but I don't know. I just think it's gonna be easier just to do it in single player, a bit quicker as well. I mean, there's nothing in the mall that can help you with the beginning stuff, so... Alright though, I don't mind doing a little bit of single player first. Oh, the chat on the bottom, yeah. Well, that's good, I'm not moving it again. I've moved it twice already. I'm not moving it a third time after this. That's it. It's staying where it is now. Ooh, look, Floran stuff. Just what I need for my ship. This is what I'm going to put them back in my ship, I think, when I, this character, I'm going to put plant matter blocks. Perfect for it. It'd be such a slow process though, because it's like everything's slow again. Yeah, very standard, very slow. Awful, I know. I don't necessarily need to go and make the hunting bow to get the steak. You can get it normally, it just takes a lot longer. There we go. There was a campfire back this way, so I might as well just go use that. Because there's no point me making one. I'd rather use them anyway, so. Ah, look at the bunny rabbits. Oh, the bunnies. There I'll just check on my Twitter on my phone because it's a bit easier than changing screens, sort of. That should be enough, because then I can craft the, let's put the crafting table down, then pick the crafting table up, take it with me to the outpost. You know. Like, yay! Make the things. Break the things. Remake the things. Oh, I do need the campfire, okay, one campfire coming up. Right, back digging again. Because that's another thing as well. I think you can get some of the other materials, like, but they're really, I think most people have got the higher stuff to sell them more. It's not like real low stuff, so it's all really good, but if you need the lower stuff then it's not so good. probably be sand as well at some point, because you know you need to make glass one of the quests to make something else. I need sand. Whoops. That's gonna be like the really fine sand. Like a little gopher thing or something. Not quite so. Already got my second piece of raw steak. And there's it going, oh, you need to make this, this, and this to get the raw steak. And I mean, no, you don't really. It looks like a big giant mole. It probably is. Probably is a big giant mole. Oh. I didn't want to go all the way down there, but. Oh, it's passive, okay. Quite nice. Not used to finding like passive things on the ground. Usually it's more of a case of, oh, okay, well that's not passive. Kind of thing, so. Then I was like, suddenly thought for a second, oh, I've definitely got my double jump. And I was like, no, I haven't. I always forget that with a new character that I don't have the text I have on it that I did on the, previous character. Ooh. I love the fact that you can actually destroy bugs like that just by using a. No, I don't know why I'm just leaving these. I could just take these with me. It gives me storage for my ship. I'm only gonna have what, literally what I have right now, which is the hull. Which isn't gonna last forever. Apparently nothing, but at the same time something. Oh no, not those. These are nasty. Are you off now, Timbers, are you? What did something happen, ABS? No, okay. I thought for a second then that my ABS had actually stopped because you went bye-bye and you didn't say anything else, bye-bye. Because, you know, it's not like my ABS hasn't done that already. That Tuesday enough times. I ate Tilly steak there. Tiny, tiny. Look at those fish. There's fish chasing me. I think they are. I think those fish are following me. That's really creepy. I hope it's because they're like nice, nice, friendly fish and not nasty, nasty fish. I'll go and I need to catch fish anyway, like make it get the actual fish the food. Well, not fish food, but you know what I mean. The fishies. Get the raw fish, that's what I needed. Yeah, I think Tibbers has already left now. He does that. Comes and goes. It fell into the water. Okay, that's cool. I see. Batty thing with long tongue, I don't know what you are, but you just... Fine. These fish had it coming. They kept following me and looking, giving me weird looks. How much copper in there have I got? I'll just get a little bit more, I think that's all I need really, because I mean I can do the stuff with the burying plants thing on the ship, you know, I don't necessarily need to really go on the planet. Well, it might be easier to do it with a single player though. Nope. Every time. Bloody fire. Well, at least it, like, lit up the place. I knew it was there, but... Jeez. That should be more than enough iron and stuff now. To get any more. No, I'm not doing the. I don't think I'm gonna dig down for the planet though. Might actually come back on the server just to get those 4 fragments because those are tedious as hell. There we go. Now I've got some decent armor to wear. Check it some real quick. Oh yeah. So I still have I'll get the hoe one, make the hoe. I make the hoe. So I could do it with my ship, but my ship's not very big, so I really don't want to have to do it there, so do it here. I don't know how my floor is like got water dripping off of it. Got wet in the rain. Oh, what, in the character section? What, here? You've got your armor one, which is actually the gear slot, and then this is like your, what's the word for it? Sort of more appearance kind of slot, so what you put over the top isn't going to protect you, but it will just be how your gear then looks, so that's why you got the two slots, so you can have like a cosmetic look and the actual armor underneath. So for example, if you get some gear and it doesn't look that great, you can put stuff that looks nice on top of it. I didn't do it with my glitch because I quite liked the armor my glitch was wearing. Whereas my neighbor kid, I didn't particularly like the next gear up stuff. It looked a bit derpy. No. You only get what these three slots give you. So if I put that there, you see how everything has gone down stat-wise. Whereas wearing it puts the stats up. It doesn't increase when it's in these slots. This is just like a basic say, instead of having those leggings, it just looks like I'm wearing the basic stuff, but it doesn't add anything extra to it at all. It's just cosmetic. It's a bit like in Terraria, you've got the two slots as well in there. You've got the gear that gives you protection and all the stats and everything, and then you've got the slots that give you the cosmetic, so you can wear costumes on top. I even need to pick these up, but hey. Right, let's go back up the ship. I've done that bit now, so I'm just gonna go. Yeah, they're all cosmetic, yeah. There's no stat improvements, unfortunately. It'd be cool. But yeah, it's not. So I can probably come back on the server now real quick. So I'm not gonna dig through the earth for the cosmetics, because I've done it enough times now. I don't think I really need to keep doing it over and over again. I think everyone's got the gist of it. You dig right straight down into the center, and that's literally where the core fragments are. So I really can't bother to dig them again, because especially not with the slow means of doing it. It's like no, much quicker to do it here. So yeah, basically the quests are exactly the same. None of them really change. It's just literally all I'm getting is just a different ship and different armor and stuff. The landlord. Oh, his script is in that bin. Everyone wants stuff like, I want this, I want that. Like, I want all these things, but when you get near me, I'm gonna run away from you. Because that's the logic way to handle quest. Okay, cool jacket again. So I should be able to get out of the solar system pretty soon, because I'll be able to do the mission, I think, once. Maybe, I don't know. Oh, that's what it's all about being a landlord then, because you get that. Okay, yeah. I'll have to try that out at some point, but do that like in single player, because although I can get a really far out planet, and I'm pretty sure obviously if I was streaming it and someone did something and I came back and it was all broken, I could have the proof and get it sorted. The thing is, I just don't want to risk it, because it would be tedious having to report it and everything. Whoa. You have a quest. Come back, Kiki. Go with the mask. Come back. No, you're going to go with the run, aren't you? So I'm going to come back down here. You're going to jump down anyway, because that's what you all do. You do loops. He wants a cake, which I can get two parts of it from here. I want one egg. Milk. Just have to go and get the sugar. Fluffy Ruffs, what is that? White coffee porridge, Fluffy Ruffs, pearl of pea pancakes. Hmm. Obviously, I'm not gonna have to play out all that stuff, you know. I will move this all around once I get put out. I can make call on the cop. That white coffee, lovely. Yep. Oh, I missed that, but I need to make the crafting thing. Cool jacket, which is 20 fabric. I can make all the floral and stuff I wanted to, but. That just looks silly. Really does. Oh. No. Oh, no, 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 no. I just realized something. I need to probably go back on single player to get diamond because I might search to see if there's any planets I can find here, but I don't think there is. I don't think any of these planets really. So I'd imagine they'd have to reset these planets each time anyway for new people because the amount of time they would get dug into would probably be pretty ridiculous. I'm gonna die when I get down here, but I can beam straight up if I do. Because the spawn planet is supposed to be like really nasty anyway. Would you look at that? I had no idea this was actually the planet that had them all on it, but would you look at that? Found the planet that had them all on it. Oh my god. I did want to come here. I needed to get 20 core fragments, so it's all good. It's just no one sells diamonds, and it's like, these, you know, there's only like a few things you need to really get for the tutorial stuff, and it'd be really nice if someone did sell them. If they put them in the shops here, because that'd be great. It can't really fly out of the spawn area. Oh, capes. I want to see what other capes there might be, actually, because I might get by myself a cape. Although they think the capes are free, actually, so. I'm pretty sure some of this stuff is in relevant to Terraria, because that's like, that looks like Terraria stuff. That looks like something from Terraria. No. This stuff is weird. No, that's stuff, isn't it? Get one of those. That'll help when I need to get out flying. Oh wow, that gives you boosts and everything, look at that. They give you no poison, I'm guessing, plus health, plus Jesus, okay. What's that? Someone put black writing or something? Crazy. What? That gives you a jump boost or something? Wow, that does give you a jump boost. I think I might just put these on as cosmetic and not have them as actual proper gear, because I don't want the boosts, I just want a nice looking cape. You know? I'm gonna use the red cape, look at that. Dun, 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 dun. Okay, I've got the core fragments that I came for. I got distracted by the cave, so like, ooh, shiny things. Must look at these, you know. Ah. No. I'm sure someone typed and it was like a big blankness. Was that, why is there something blank? Wait, hang on. I'm sure it said I needed the, No, I picked up the wrong thing, didn't I? But, oh, at least I got the fragments now, because I know I think I need the fragments for stuff anyway, so... Instant swag, yeah. Okay, Jay is. I just realized Jay's the hotkey for the quest, so I don't need to keep clicking up there. Take diamond. Steel armor, iron furnace, metal workstation. Unrefined wood again. I can make the glass though. If anyone needed the glass. 6 pieces of glass, okay, that's great. Yeah, so I'm gonna have to get back into single player for a little bit. So, back we go. Back over to single player. Because I can't bother to keep flying around different planets to find out whether I can leave and land on them and stuff. It's much easier if I just come back on single player where I know I'm at a starting planet that will give me the stuff I need to have. It's a little bit easier because I obviously probably have to try and figure it out on the server, which is a little bit tedious. Take this campfire. No one needs it. I'll get some wood anyway. Someone's messaging me on here going, are you real? I don't know who the hell they are. Oh, it's not on here, but you know what I mean? On TeamSpeak, sorry. No idea who they are. They've not got a regular thing on the TeamSpeak that I'm using, so they're probably just some random who's jumping channels. Whatnot. You usually get that. Yeah, I mean, that's alright. I mean, they, you know, it is a public one, so anyone can join, but obviously if they piss about, then they won't be able to join for long. So, it's all good. It's all good. Right, so it is as well as that I've actually got mod on this TeamSpeak I'm on, so anyone does start pissing about and trying to it's about on the TeamSpeak whilst I'm streaming. It's just a case of no, I can kick him. Like, oi, get out. Get out of it. Like, you can play silly buggers in your own time. It's always good. I mean, the server I use for Starbound does have their own TeamSpeak, but then that's always the worry, is like, because the way Rhea set up the Just Gaming TeamSpeak is that people can't actually poke you on TeamSpeak, because what she found is that whenever she was playing games full screened, it used to pull her straight out of the game kind of thing. And it used to get so annoying because people used to always do it. If people were streaming, they just deliberately poked people to pull them out of the game. And so Rhea was like, no, we're taking that method out. People can't poke you. They can message you, but they can't poke you. So that's the brilliance of it, you know, because the messaging side of things doesn't make a great deal of noise. Plus, I have my TeamSpeak turned right down anyway. Like, I have the sound effects on it turned down because it can usually be really noisy. I'm thinking, well, when I'm in a locked channel, the only people that are usually going to get in are people that I've given the password to. So, there are not going to be any surprises. I don't need to pay attention to who joins the channel. Whilst I'm on the planet, I should keep going and seeing if I can find some diamonds. Diamonds. Ah! I thought that was coming after me. It's a bloody armadillo. Scared me, armadillo. No, I don't know who that guy is. I closed the conversation over it is. I mean, if they'd have been someone that wanted trusted, or not trusted, but the one at the regular thing, I would have given it to them, but if they're just going to play silly buggers and just put a random message and they're not signing anything, it's like, ah, okay, you're on your own. Leave me to it. I mean, I have so many TeamSpeaks I could use. I mean, I could use the Bacon TeamSpeak, I could use the NGGS TeamSpeak that Oshu has. If it's working. I mean, last time I checked it wasn't working, but, you know, I've still got that, I can use that. I think Iron, Copper, Steel or something. So yeah, so I've got quite a few to use. To play multiplayer, you can host it if you can figure that out. It is a bit tricky. It's not like Terraria where you can use Hamachi. It has its own little server boxing. Or you can Google up Starbound servers on Google and there will be something called Starbound's hyphen server list, I think. And that will give you a list of servers to join. Bearing in mind, most of the top servers are password locked, so you have to join their site in order to get the password. That's the only two ways of really playing multiplayer at the moment. Starbound's still in beta, so there isn't really much option. So it is kind of usually, you know, you either host it or you find one that's being hosted, that kind of thing. I'm currently doing this in single player because the server I play on doesn't really have a good starting area to do the tutorial quests. So I'm getting the tutorial quests done in single player. Or at least getting the parts for the tutorial quest kind of thing. No problem. It does, yeah, it does let you see a little bit, but it's very small. It's very, very small. I think the torch can sometimes do a bit of a better job sometimes, depending on how close you are to the darkness and everything, so if you're close to the surface, another trick I usually find is like during the daytime, you can break the background and it will let a little light through. Obviously once you get deep underground it doesn't do it, but oh, it's much better when you've got the biggest size though for it, because having like the 2x2 isn't all that great really. It's all right, but I mean, oh my god, there's an umbrella. We can have a parasol, there we go. Oh my god. That's hilarious. I start singing the umbrella song about being under my umbrella. Mm-hmm. I was waiting for you to notice it. Yep. But you come here enough times, so... And if Osha and Tibbers aren't on, it's always good to have like an extra person around. You can be mod... Put my drink up. No problem. I just thought it made sense. You do come on quite a bit now, and it's... I did say the other day I kind of need to start getting a few more mods. But it's always a bit tricky because, you know, you can't just give it to anyone because you never know what someone's going to be like someone random, for example. Yes, you have the power! You have a little green sword you can bop people on the head with now. Bop! I also think it's nice, you know, if you get these regulars, it's quite nice to give them the chance to kind of, you know, help keep an eye on chat and stuff. I mean, my chat doesn't get too hectic, so it's all good. I only get the occasional troll come in, but I've noticed one thing is that you get it more with Minecraft than you do other games. Like, Minecraft tends to bring the trolls. You'd be surprised how many trolls I've had on Minecraft when I've done it. One of the reasons why I kind of took a little bit of a step back from streaming it is because you used to get trolls quite often. And not only that, I kind of got bored of the game entirely as well in general. I started playing, I think, Pixel Sparks the other day, and it was ridiculous because it was on a server that I used to actually be staffed for. And I thought, oh, just come on. I don't think anyone's going to really make a fuss of me being there. And it's like, so many people were like, oh my god, Reva, you're back. Where have you been? It's like, you kind of disappeared. It's crazy. Like, past 3 days, I've been playing past 3 days Pixel Sparks, and I've just had non-stop people going, oh my god, Reva. But most of them have had name changes since then as well. So a lot of them were new names, and I was thinking, I don't know who you are. And then they go, do you remember me? And I'm like, no. And I'm like, oh yeah, I had a name change. And it's like, oh, okay. Yeah, that's why I don't recognize you. But then I sat there and was like, to some of the people that I really don't recognize, even though they probably recognize me really well. And it's like, try not to take too offensive if I don't recognize you. Because I was staffed back when they saw me on there, I was like, it's usually a good thing if I don't, because if it's usually a bad thing if I do, it's usually it means they got in trouble a lot, and I had to deal with them, so... It's like, nah, it's a good thing if I don't remember you. It means you didn't get in trouble. It means I didn't have to deal with you getting in trouble. No, going to cause a lot of snow avalanche. Not snow, sand. That's the word. Sand. Yeah. Terrible. Right. Yeah, I didn't ever do any gym stuff. I did the surf side of things, which it's all right, but the main age group in Pixelmon is mostly like kids and teenagers, so it gets a little bit kind of over the top sometimes with some stuff that you have to deal with, but yeah, all the sand. I do this every time. I think, oh, I'm gonna break something, and then it's just, oh, all the sand comes on. But at least it's going down somewhere else. I'm getting free stuff from it. I don't have to mine any of the sand. Look at it. I'm getting free sand. And pixels. Somewhere I'm getting pixels. Up in the top right, this little bit up here. You still got 990 pixels at the moment. That's your pixels. Up there. Jumping, I think, to the left by me. I think I heard something jumping anyway. You see all the sand is gone, it's hilarious. All like drifted on the side here. Get the item whilst I'm here, because I need to make steel to make the next stuff, so all good. Digging down, I think. Go and get some diamonds. Something probably flying nearby, because that's what I can hear. Diamonds! We really had dirt already. Oh, you right click with the tool, you just right click it. Instead of left clicking, which is usually break things to the foreground, you right click for the background. You'd think it would explain that in the tutorial as well. I don't think it does. I think it just kind of expects people to know it from the previous lot of the Starbound when you played it for the first time kind of thing. Like before they had all these other quests and stuff. Well, it's a tortoise. Oh, I just hit the microphone a little bit there. But I really hope that I didn't pick that up. I think I only needed to get one diamond in order to get the coordinates or something. Yeah. Okay, so... Oh, same quit. I think it'll keep me on the planet anyway, it doesn't matter, but we just gotta be put the password in. Like, I'm not be actually going away, I'm just, you know, putting the BRB screen up. I'm gonna put the password back. So I don't really actually have to put it in. That's the bright side of not actually closing my client down, is that it keeps the password there. It's only whenever you close the client down that it removes it and everything, which is really tedious if you're just using the same IP and, you know, same things. They could get back on the server, because usually there's 33 people on apparently right now, so the glass. What do I need to steal? I don't know if I like the headpiece, but there's no way to, you know, not show the headpiece, that's a problem. I'd like to do the first boss, which, you know, last time I was actually really lucky and I did it on my own and it was fine, but I know I haven't got the barely any of the gear right now to do it. So it's gonna be tricky because I ain't got any decent weapons at the moment. Like, my swords aren't gonna cut it. Although I don't necessarily need to really worry about the swords, it's more of just with that particular boss, it's more of just focusing on getting the cannon set up, like the laser. So if you have a lot of bandages on you, you should really be all right doing it, because I think you just keep doing mass heals constantly. So, you know, there's that. See. Although I don't think I really want to go and do that today, because I'm probably not going to do too much of a stream tonight. Because I don't usually stream on the Fridays, so So far I've done about almost 5 hours today. I'm gonna try and do more tomorrow. But tomorrow's gonna try and be a sort of mix between Starbound and the Wolf Among Us tomorrow. One. That's right, I can't use the thrusters, can I? I want to do the mining facility. No money. Not yet. What's what this planet's like? They must have done something to the planet since spawn, because the fact is you can land on the moor and the moor says it's a dangerous planet, you know, it's like it's scorching, it's gonna burn you kind of thing, yet you don't burn when you're at the moor. It's really bizarre how this happens to be the spawn area, but because usually the spawn area is like a general solar system. Because there's no way in hell you could go on a dangerous planet as a new character without dying. Happens. Yeah, burning. Pretty burning. Cannot go on these other planets. And the other one's too cold. Just dangerous low. Yeah. Temperature dangerously low, temp low, temperature dangerously high, 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 temperature dangerously low. So it's like, you know, literally these are the only two, that's the spawn on a moon, so there literally isn't anything else I can do around here. I mean, the only place I can really go and get weapons from is I can get some from the mall, but again, they're a little bit kind of op. Unless I have a look in the mall and see if there's anything low spec that I can use. I'm not gonna do the mining facility today. I'll probably leave that for tomorrow because just in case that I get any problems with it, you never know. It might be better to try it when there's less people on as well, because there's like what. 32 players on, which means there's like 8 slots left for the before the server's full. So that won't be too fun if blah blah blah. If my FPS drops like it normally does, I said, although I'm not sure whether it is because because I was in a party when I did it. Because both times I've had the problems, I've been in a party when I've done it. But when I haven't been in a party is the only time it didn't happen. Now I don't know if that is just... Oh, sorry, I don't know if it's just a multiplayer thing where you can't go... Where I can't do it as a party because it just wraps my FPS out. Or if it's just... Your luck that I happened to be able to do it the other day. There's that, which gives you like more damage. And then it takes 3 shots to do that, so I'm just going off again. Okay, that was just like a bit going off again. There's this one. Might be be alright as a gun, you know. Try it out, see what it's like. I'll leave it for tomorrow, obviously. I'm not gonna, do it today. So let's see. We got supply. Put that away because I don't need that. Thought I needed it, but I don't. Oh, I had that gun though. But look, it's one damage per shot, whereas this one's like four. So I'll just stick with that for now. What this does. Okay, I probably won't still be here in the hour. I'm probably going to be gone by then. Oh, this umbrella looks silly. I'll see you next time, Ari. See you later. Here, so I can. Gonna check what this umbrella is. No problems. So good, so good. I was like trying to see if that would like work like this whole float down thing, but I don't quite get what it does. It's like you open the umbrella. Maybe it's just to stop the rain from getting on me. I don't know. Just if the arc's changed at all. I don't think it has, but still as dark as ever. Nah, it hasn't changed. That's still. I'm not gonna worry about it. I'll look at it next time. Yeah. I was like, can I get out of here? And it's like, nope, machine's not working. You can't go anywhere. Right. So that's the beginning of my Floran character. So I've completed my Nova Kid, I completed my glitch. This is the third character in the running that I've done. I will be streaming again tomorrow. I mean I've got so many days now that I can stream on, but I don't necessarily mean I'm gonna do massive amount of hours of streaming. I'll just try and spread it out a little bit over the days and stuff. So I hope you guys have enjoyed the stream today, and I hope to see you guys next time. Bye guys.